Hey guys, today I'm playing a little more Besiege, because there's been a little update. There haven't been any new levels, to my knowledge at least. But you can see up here it's version 0.09, and they've just added a few things. They do this quite a bit, actually. They add a few extra little things, like parts, every now and again. So I just want to take a look at that. Just some of the new parts, because they're kind of good. There's only a few, but yeah, I wanted to cover this. I just like covering Besiege. Because you guys seem to like it, and I love the game, and even when they add like a little thing, it just lets me know that they're working hard. So we'll go to the Queen's Fodder, because this is actually quite good for what I want to show. They've added kind of, a Blunderbuss type part, if you will. I'll show you that in a second. I'll just make myself a frame. I guess I'll put wheels on it. I'll try and do this reasonably quickly. And they've changed the menu system. They've got now locomotion and mechanical are different things, so wheels and like springs and stuff are separate, which is really nice. I do very much like that. So yeah, let's just build ourselves a fairly sturdy thing, and the steering parts are now in mechanical. Oh no, locomotion, which is nice because this looks like a lot of the mechanical parts, so it's kind of nice that they've made it such that you know, they're separate now. Unpowered wheel? No, we want motor wheel. Just little ones will be fine. Oh, nope, that's no good. That work? Yeah, no, those are the wrong way around. There we go. Come on. And let's just speed all of these things up, just to make this run a little smoother. Yeah, I have to say, I am impressed constantly by this game. Just by... I've said it before, and I hate having to say... I hate saying this, but I am so impressed just by how they've just clearly seen exactly what they want to do. They haven't got caught up. They're clearly programmers, basically. Since it just works. Oh god damn, I'm screwing this all up. But yeah, they clearly know what they're doing. They've clearly developed something before. They've clearly, you know, just done this right and done it well, so it works. But yeah, now that's much faster. But yeah, it's very nice. Anyway, the new parts they've added. They've actually added a couple of mechanical parts. These small wheels, which are kind of like trolley wheels, or what's that in America? Like a shopping cart, you know, like those weird little wheels that kind of do 360 degrees. And it's unpowered, but you can see as I turn, it kind of turns with you. So you could make like a little ejectable cart or something, or maybe just some support like that to make it a little more stable. So that's quite nice. They've also added a large cog. Because they've always had these little cogs, and they've added large wheels, so I guess it kind of goes with that. But yeah, large cogs could be really good for like, I don't know, I think, actually these cogs allow you to put things, yeah, that's what they're for. They're for putting multiple things on there, so you can put, rather than just having one attachment point, they have multiple attachment points. And how do these work? I didn't actually, oh, it's unpowered. But yeah, basically it just allows you to attach multiple things, which could be really useful for, I don't know, like a massive rotor. Ooh, yeah, let's demonstrate that. I wonder if I can make this spin. Because it's unpowered. But yeah, so if I put just a powered cog underneath it, and then put this on top, power this up to full speed, and then throw a bunch of these on here. Ooh, we've got to put this on the ground. We're in the box, of course. I'll put that on there. And then, yeah, I could make a... Ooh, I could make like a mecha... freaking helicarrier is what I've been thinking about with this giant cog. Is that's a lot more rotors. Wait, no, it's not. That's the exact same amount of rotors. Well, either way, it's awesome. Yeah, there's probably better uses for that, but still, I think it's a nice idea. Oh yeah, of course you could put some on here like that. Oh yeah, you could really mecha crap there. Anyway, yeah, you can see you can just attach so much stuff to this, so you could make like gigantic rotors for lifting crazy heavy things or whatever you plan. I'll just get rid of all this. But they've got some other parts as well, not just little, well, big cogs, I guess. My favorite new one is the, I think it's called the Shrapnel Cannon? Yeah, Shrapnel Cannon. It's just like a blunderbuss, as you'll see here. It's good for taking out, basically, people. As they get closer, you'll be able to see that you can just... That broke. I'm gonna strut that up so it breaks less. It might be a little better. I'll demonstrate it in a second with, I'll demonstrate it with slow motion so you can see exactly what it's doing. But yeah, a shrapnel cannon, it's like a burst fire that's really good for just taking out loads of people, as you can see there. That just quite wrecked. So we'll slow that down to, really slow. We'll take our run. I'm going to slow it down even more, actually, just so you can see exactly what's happening. So when we fire, it ejects a lot of shrapnel, and it can take out like a whole bunch of people. Wouldn't be very good about against structures like the cannon, I guess, but that is quite effective against people, and that is quite nice. I do very much like that. I don't know what else they've added. They've a small wheel, a large unpowered cog, obviously the new menu system. Have they added any more weapons? No, I think all these are pretty much the same, but yeah. Yeah, pretty much. They've just clearly constantly updating it, and I think this friction pad was in the last update, but it could be quite good for something like drags itself along. But yeah, I thought I'd just quickly, you know, talk about all the new parts, because there's so much cool stuff you can do with this, and like, this freaking just... Oh, you could totally make like a flail with this. But yeah, Besiege is just, as I've always said, just an awesome game. And I like even when they do these little updates that just allow me to blast people a little more easily. It's just nice to know that, you know, they are constantly updating this and just... And, you know, last time they put a bunch of new levels in and that was awesome. But, you know, small updates are also awesome. But yeah, it's just clearly one of these games that's probably going to be a full game not that long from now. They've just got to make a lot of levels, I guess. And maybe put in new parts because they've got the system done. They just have so much time to just make levels now, I guess. Oh my god, did I just win? Yeah, pretty much. So yeah, I guess they're just working on content and probably, hopefully, a few optimizations. Wow, I won! That's incredible. didn't do anything, but they're all dead, so that's good. Anyway, yeah, so this has already gone on way too long, so I hope you have enjoyed this. This has been Besiege 0.09. I will see you next time.